So hello friends, welcome to this class. So today we are going to design for a connecting rod. So we have made into a short way to understand the problem. So step by step, all the formulas I will tell you how to start the design. You have to understand the working of the connecting rod. So in an IC engine, where the cylinder, it is a fixed part, in that we'll have the piston, where piston that will reciprocate in the cylinder. Now at the end of the piston rod, we connected with the connecting rod, where the total length of the connecting rod is taken as L. Now another end of the connecting rod, it is connected to the crank, and another end of the crank, that is connected to the crankshaft. Okay, now coming to this point, where one end where the piston and connecting rod is connected, that is called as a smaller end, and another end where crank and connecting rod is connected, so that point we called as bigger end. Okay, so here the crank that can make the rotation, so that total length of the stroke is equal to 2 into R we will take. Okay, now after that here the force applied at the smaller end and at the sectional view and at the inner of the big end, so that should be, all forces should be equal. That is the first condition. So before starting this, we have to calculate the sum of the basic parameters of the connecting rod or cross section of the connecting rod. So we can calculate the cross section of the connecting rod by making the section. Okay, so when if you make the section, you will obtain in the I form. So here for the I section, the area of the I section, that is taken as 11 into T square, that is the area of the I section, and also this is the moment of inertia in the x axis, about the x axis, that is 419 divided by 12 T power of 4, and similarly for moment of inertia for y axis, 131 divided by 12 into T power of 4. So these two, that should be, suppose there is a ratio for these two, when it is satisfied, so we can go for the design. So what is that ratio? Here it is a ratio of I axis divided by I yy, that should be range from 3 to 3.5, that ratio should be 3 to 3.5. once it is satisfied, so we can go for the further calculation. So after satisfaction, so you need to calculate the radius of gyration in the I axis. So I, about the I axis, that value will be 1.78 into T. So that is the radius of gyration. So once we calculated the radius of gyration, then you have to apply in the Rankine formula. So after the all these calculation, we have to go to the Rankine formula. So it is also called as buckling load. Okay, so is equal to sigma C A divided by 1 plus A in the bracket L by radius of gyration in x axis whole power of this calculation. We have to go to the buckling load, or it is also called as Rankine's formula. So here sigma C is nothing but it is an compressive yield stress, and A is the cross sectional area of the connecting rod, plus 1 plus A, where A value will be 1 divided by 7500 in the bracket, L is nothing but it is the length of the connecting rod, and radius of the gyration in x axis, power of 2. Okay, so you need to substitute all these values if they have mentioned in the question. So after that you need to calculate the length of the crank. So length of the crank, so R is equal to L by 2, so that is the length of the crank you will get, small r, number stroke of the piston divided by 2 you will get. After that, you can calculate the length of the connecting rod. The length of the connecting rod, the total length of the connecting rod, L, you have to take L, whatever the given value. So that is equivalent to the length of the connecting rod for both the ends. Okay, from the both the ends, fixed to the fixed. So now we will go for applying the Rankine formula or according to the buckling load. So here this is an stress value that should be taken as 320 megapascal, and cross sectional area we already obtained here, and divided by length and divided by radius of gyration in the x axis. So radius of gyration k axis is equal to under root of I axis divided by a. So you will obtain the k x axis. Okay. So after that, you will obtain a quadratic equation from this formula. Okay. So once we made the quadratic equation, you will obtain the two values. So positive value should be taken for the thickness of the web. So generally the thickness of the web we can obtain using this equation. Okay. So after obtaining the thickness of the web, we can calculate the other parameters in the I sections, like where B it will be called as width of the section, and H it will be called as height or depth of the section. So after calculating width and height, you need to calculate the some other parameter by taking the proportions, like we can go for calculating other parameters like h1, h2. So h1, h2 will be the depth near the big end and depth near the smaller end. So some other parameter we can easily calculate using the thickness proportions. So after that the main important thing is to making the dimension for crank pin and for the big end bearing and also for piston pin. Okay. So these parameter you can calculate by equating these two equation. Okay. So by using these two equation, we can get the diameter for the crank pin and diameter for the crank pin, and also this is for diameter of the piston pin. DP is for diameter of the piston pin and diameter of the crank pin. So piston pin will be this one DP, and DC will be the diameter of the larger end. So you have to calculate these two by equating the equation. So other parameter you have to look here. So from that, once we calculated these two values, so now we will go to calculate the size of bolts for securing the big end cap. Okay. So this is the size of the bigger end. Okay. So here the number of bolts are going to be used here. So you need to calculate the stresses in the bolt, and also you need to calculate the inertia forces at the bolt. Okay. So first here DC, that is indicates that it is the core diameter of the bigger end, and for the bolt size, so here there is an equation for MR omega square R 1 plus R by L. So from this equation, again for the inertia force, that should be equal to the tensile force. Again we can calculate the for the tensile force for the bolt, 2 into pi by 4 d square into sigma t. So using this equation you will get the nominal size of the bolt. So nominal size of the bolt, that is db is equal to dc by 0.84. So that value you will get. After that, the thickness of the big end cap. So thickness of the big end cap, here z is equal to lc into tc square divided by 6 we can take here. So after that, you can calculate the stresses in the connecting rod. So that is an whipping stresses, sigma w is equal to mi divided by j, where mi you can calculate the maximum bending stress, m omega square r l divided by 9 root 3. So using this equation you will get the whipping stresses. So these are the some formulas I have made into one sheet solution, so you can refer while solving the problem. So thank you for watching.